Okay, round two. Name something that's not boring.
A laundry? Ooh, a book club. Computer solitaire, huh?
Ah, oh, sorry. We were looking for Chumba Casino.
That's right. Chumbacasino.com has over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
With Lucky Land Slots, you can get lucky just about anywhere.
This is your captain speaking. We've got clear runway and the weather's fine, but we're just going to circle up here a while and get lucky. No, no, nothing like that. It's just these cash prizes add up quick. So I suggest you sit back, keep your tray table upright, and start getting lucky.
Play for free at LuckyLandSlots.com. Are you feeling lucky? No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
The stars at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of Texas, the prairie sky.
You can convey that information.
Wide and high.
If this is a game of telephone, that's not going to end well for you.
Yes. It's a game of cell phone, and my carrier is AT&T.
Oh, God. At least you're not Sprint. At least you're not Sprint.
Sprint. The poor people's cell phone network. Remember the Nextel phones? Did you ever think that that was going to be a long-term solution? Or is that was that just a flash in the pan and kids will never understand the Nextel thing?
Kids will be like, bloop, bloop, what's that mean? But my wife had that when I met her, and yeah. I made her change it instantly.
Or Blackberries. Like, even the concept of Blackberries.
And then, weren't they Blueberries, and then they went to Blackberries?
Something like that.
And then remember the Sidekicks?
Yes.
That's where I took my wife to.
Oh, yeah, Sidekicks. I remember Sidekicks.
Me and Paris Hilton were tight back then. When they came out.
Yeah.
We were hanging out all the time.
Yeah, I remember. Remember those
days. It was great.
Yeah.
Nicole Richie, like Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah. Jeez. So,
what show is this again?
This is our live episode, coronavirus free live episode.
This is a live episode.
Or we are alive.
Yeah.
I meant by that.
That's a podcast name already taken. We're living.
We're living. So, this is recorded live before a studio audience.
No, that's not
how that worked either.
Before a pool.
Okay, how does podcasting and radio work? I don't understand the concept.
It doesn't matter. That's not the point of the conversation. The point of the conversation is that you're moving.
I am officially moving. I will not be a Californian here in a very short while, about 10 days.
That's not true. You'll actually be a Californian until you live somewhere for longer than you lived in California.
Well, then I'm always going to be a Californian because if I'm 40 and I live where
I'm
living.
Oh, yeah, you're Californian for your life. You're dead
soon. Right, because I'm going to be dying by 60. So.
Yeah, I just crossed.
What is the rule for that, by the way? How long do you have to live somewhere before you could say that you're, like, you've lived in California now for a while,
yes,
but can you say that you're a Californian?
Yes, I've actually lived in California longer than anywhere else in my life. So technically,
wow,
I'd be a Californian. Now, I am lucky. I didn't move here until I was in my 20s.
Right.
I got 20 more years to make a choice to get out or not.
Ah, yes. This is true.
So, where you make the choice right now.
I'm making the choice right now. So, yes, we've officially decided to leave California.
They are moving to Dubai.
Dubai. Listen, we love sand. And I said, where can I go that has a lot of sand?
And then I said Vegas. And he said, there's shutdown.
No. And then I wanted to go where my lifestyle could be appreciated. You know, I like living large. Bugattis, McLarens, driving fast. And then I also want camels. So,
don't they have Ronda Rousey jumping out of, like, building to building in Dubai?
Something like that. I hear that's a thing as well.
It's like Fast 13.
Yeah, something like that. So, we are actually moving to the great state of Texas. Excuse me, the Republic of Texas, as they call it there.
Oh, you're not allowed to call it a state?
No, they are firmly say that they are Republic of Texas. They are very independent, which is something I like. They actually, did you know they have their own electrical grid? So the entire rest of the United States shares electrical grids.
Yes.
Texas has its own.
So if
we get, like, terrorists attacked into our electrical grid, Texas will be like, no, we're cool, we're fine. Our electric's working just fine.
That'll be great because you guys have the Alamo.
Right, and I remember it.
Yeah, well, I mean, I was in the basement that one
time. Yeah, that one time.
Yeah, but, I mean, other than that, you have what, the cheating Astros?
We have the cheating Astros, which
Cowboys.
I will get to now boo in person.
Oh, the in person, too. That'll be great.
Yeah, in person booing.
In your Angels jacket.
In my Angels jacket, of course. The Dallas Cowboys, which I think I'm required to be a fan of the Cowboys by, like, law. I think when you move there... Like, I don't like the Cowboys, but I think legally I'm now obligated to like the Cowboys.
No, I don't think you're allowed to until they pay you for it.
Because
I'm pretty sure that the Dallas Cowboys pay all their fans.
You think that's
if
how
you ever see their stadium?
Is that why they're
TV,
all such jerks?
Yeah, they're all assholes, and a lot of the tickets are free, so nobody shows up that cares.
Yeah. Now, I know, but we'll have to love college football and high school football, though, right?
Oh, God, yeah. Friday Night Lights might mean something a little more to you.
My daughter's high school football stadium holds 20,000 people.
That's more than the
That's more than the Staples
Center.
Pretty much most
baseball teams.
The Staples Center holds like 19,000.
Angel Stadium's 14K.
No, that's just how many show up.
Oh, okay. That's right. Sorry, that's the pond.
Yeah.
Pond's 14K.
Yeah, something like
stadium's 33.
Yeah, it's a 20,000 seat high school football stadium.
Okay, is there a reason for that?
I think it's one of the things that everyone does in the local area. Like, people go to the games that don't even have kids that go to the school.
Why?
I think it's something to do on a Friday night, and it's like their religion.
Do they not have alcohol?
Like, family, football, and the Lord, not in that order exactly.
What's your order? You're like, booze, my kids, and...
Yeah, more booze.
Not family or football, or football or...
I mean, I would actually, right now, put baseball ahead of football just because I miss baseball so much, but... No, but yeah, we're excited. So it's a move, and I know you went through it. You moved from Washington to our beautiful state of California. But I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking of all the things that I'm actually gonna miss, and besides the obvious, like family,
you're not gonna miss them.
It's pretty much just the perfect weather.
I mean,
and that's it. That's all. That's really it.
But the perfect weather from your windshield when you're sitting in traffic for 6 hours is not great.
Yeah, and as someone who I know you have spent many hours sitting behind a windshield.
Yes.
Yeah, you do spend a lot of windshield time here, and so you're right. The weather is not always appreciated.
Yeah, when you're
because we're inside.
When your commute's going to be 10 minutes just because it's actually 10 minutes away.
Right.
You're going to be like, I could live with this for a while.
So I currently live about 17 miles from downtown L.A.
Yes.
It takes me an hour and like 15 minutes, hour and 20 minutes to get there.
It used to take me an hour and 30 just to get home
exactly.
At night when we record the podcast.
Right. So I am currently, my new city is going to be about 17 miles from downtown Dallas. It took us 28 minutes. To get to downtown Dallas.
The grassy knoll or the book suppository building?
It's not a suppository. It does not go in your butt.
Book depository building.
Yes. Book depository building. Yes, wait. We're about 17 miles from the book depository building.
So do you slide the book in the slot?
That's what we call what we do in the bedroom.
I think I'm off a couple vowels.
Okay.
Okay.
So anyways, yeah. So have you ever thought about moving out of state?
Well,
by the way, where to? Where would you go?
Well, just to give everybody a little background, I mean, I grew up most of my life in Washington State, about 10 years. But before that 10 years, I was 10 or 11 years in Arizona, Vegas, Washington, I think.
You're a nomad.
Yeah, we've been all over because my dad, I don't know why. So anyway, yes, I would look at moving out, and I've applied for jobs at other places that might be great jobs.
Yeah.
Like the, oh my God, I caught the biggest fish in
the
pond.
Yeah, 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 yeah. The ones where you're like, are they sure they said yes? Like,
know,
to
right?
me, right?
like
they knew it was me?
Like, let me spell my name back for you so you make sure it's the right person. So, but yeah, I totally would. And now that our oldest daughter is going into high school, I think within the next year or two would be the time for it to happen, if it was going to happen at all, because it would be before my son goes into high school.
It would make it easier just from a timeline.
Correct, but I don't really give a rat's ass about that. I've lived all over.
You've lived all over.
I've moved all over.
You have an advantage over a lot of people because so many people have only grown up in one area.
Correct.
So that move is a big move. For you, it's just like a Thursday.
Yeah, like, well, yeah. I mean, drink Tequila Thursdays, right?
Tequila Thursdays.
So yeah, but no, it's just like even I talk to Evelyn all the time. She's like, "Well, I'm so worried. Like, it's going to be different." And I'm like, "Yeah, but difference good. Believe me, it costs less.
Way
California,
less.
Yeah. There's a lot of letters because we pay for every single one. Like, we don't live in like Utah.
One of them, just wear four or five letter states. Yeah.
But yeah, no, I would move almost anywhere.
What is your top five states that you would never move to? That, like, I don't care if someone said, this is a dream job, but it's in, like, I don't know, North Dakota or whatever. Like, what are your five, there's no way in hell I'm moving their state?
Florida.
Okay.
Probably.
Even if it was south, like Key West, I could live in Key West.
I'd rather go somewhere there's not hurricanes.
Okay, good point.
Yeah, I'd hate planning for natural disasters.
Okay. Yeah. Here in LA, we don't plan for natural disasters. We just have shootings, killings, gangland executions. Right.
Unplanned for.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Like most of our pregnancies.
Unpremeditated.
Yes. Unpremeditated. That's a good one.
I don't think I would go to like. Honestly, I don't think I'd move to Detroit. I moved to Michigan, but
that's
not
a,
Detroit.
That's a tough one. I honestly, I would rule out all of Michigan for the most part, just because the weather is also pretty nasty. In the
Grand Rapids, where University of Michigan is that where that's at?
I don't know. Flint. I think they're in Flint.
Flint, yeah, yeah. I would
move
there.
Lansing.
Because I've heard lots of good things.
Yeah.
I wouldn't move to the Dakotas. I wouldn't move to
I wouldn't move to Taxachusetts.
Massachusetts? Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't think I'd move there. I don't think I'd move to Maryland.
But if you move to Massachusetts, you'll get to get called a masshole.
I'm already called that.
Yeah, no, you're an asshole now.
Oh.
But when you're there, you're a masshole.
Well, it's too many letters, man. Yeah, it's like California. I'm paying for
that,
you're
paying for every letter.
But what about you, top five?
Well, here's the thing. I could live in New York for a short period of time. Like, I could do the New York City, Manhattan, like, oh, I'm going to live there for a year and then get out. But I think anything longer than that, and that would be a nightmare. I would not want to do that.
With kids, it would be a nightmare.
Absolutely. Oh, 100%.
Without kids?
100%.
I could do a little longer.
Probably. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
But you also have to make a shit ton of money.
Oh, absolutely.
So unless you want to live in a closet.
I had a friend that he got all excited because he was offered an $80,000 a year job. Now, this is also 10 years ago, but so $80,000 is even more. But
Where?
He thought $80,000 job in New York, and he took it, and he left all the way out there thinking, I'm going to make good money on the island. And he gets there, and he realizes it's the equivalent of making like minimum wage.
Yeah, no, he didn't have a
his
place
rent,
to stay.
His rent was like $3,500 a month.
And that's ridiculous.
You know, and it's like, so he's making 80 grand a year, but he can't afford to do anything, and he's eating top ramen.
Yeah, right.
And I'm like, you know.
It's like his college days.
Exactly.
Except not making
so 80. So I would say New York just because I have a family that'd be really tough long term. I could do it for only a short period of time.
Yeah.
I would say Massachusetts only because I hate people from Boston. I would say also, like, the Philadelphia, like, the whole Pennsylvania thing.
Yeah.
I hear Pittsburgh is pretty nice, but the winters are pretty brutal.
Yes.
I don't want anything to where my testicles are going to freeze to the seat of my car. Like, that's like a good rule of thumb for me.
Yeah, but they have heated seats now.
I don't want to have heated seats so that my testicles don't freeze.
Then I'll invent heated testicles.
Ooh, I'm in. Is this like a Shark Tank? Shark Tank pitch.
It's like a little knit basket.
Hi,
balls.
Our name is Frosty Balls, and we are here looking for an investment of $10,000 for over 3% of our company.
Because we have this cool thing called Warm 'Em Up, and it's this little sack that sits around your sack
and
to make them intact.
Yeah, and it cradles them. And it allows them to breathe at the same time. Your testicles really get a lot of fresh air.
They do.
While also staying warm and toasty.
And if your wife blows on them, it's even better.
And you can upgrade for $9.95 to our special package, which guarantees that your special package will not burn or catch on fire by using our device.
Pregnancy not guaranteed.
Not guaranteed. So I would think that I couldn't do those states. But
what about like Alaska?
You know what, though? Under the right circumstances, I think I could do it. The whole concept of F the world, I'm away from everyone, is kind of appealing, to be honest with you.
And here's the thing I think that you're not recognizing about that. It's cold. Like,
cold.
All the time in Alaska.
Like, even in the like, summer, yeah. Where it's very pleasant, like, it's still pretty chilly.
The hot summer day is like 72.
Yeah.
So I think that's the biggest thing that's going to be a deterrent for any of my family members because most of them, all of them,
well, they're spoiled
not
Californians.
Yeah,
right?
Just like you.
Yeah.
So totally. I think that Texas, you'll do good, but I think that if you were to end up in like Washington, like Seattle,
it might be tough.
You'd probably Nirvana yourself.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Probably. Now, do you think? Do you think that there's like a learning curve too to how to live in another state? Because we are spoiled Californians. We're used to perfect weather. I'm waiting for the first big rainstorm, non-California rainstorm that my family's going to encounter. Now, I've been in the South when some rain has happened.
Yeah.
Where I'm talking like the earth opened up and water came out kind of rain.
Like I ate too much spicy food
like it's
Taco
bad,
Bell
right,
before. Yeah.
Right. But my family has never experienced in anything else except for light California drizzles.
And we hit those on the way on our cross-country trip to Florida.
Yeah.
We hit some of those rainstorms where Evelyn stopped.
Like you think that you have to go gather two of every animal. Like
yeah,
you're literally
right?
Thinking like, wait, is this this can't be correct?
Or why are there only two windshield wipers on my car? There should be 17.
Well, it reminds me of the Jungle Cruise ride from Disneyland when you're going through the waterfall because you don't even see rain droplets. It's sheets of water that are coming down.
It's the backside of water.
The backside of water.
Yeah. And nobody from Texas will get that. You will make that joke there.
A lot of my references are going to go completely over people's.
And then they're going to be like, hey, Magnolia, you're going to be like.
Like when someone says, oh, I'm stuck and this traffic's taking forever. And I go, yeah, like the 405 freeway going south at 4:15 p.m. And people are going to be like, wait, what do you mean by that?
And then they're
going
to change it and be like, yeah, no, that's like going to church on Sunday at David Koresh's house.
This drive is rough. And, you know, here in California, it's like, this drive is rough. Yeah, like the 110 freeway, am I right? And out here, everyone gets it. And over there, they're going to be like, what the hell are you talking about?
Like, I got baptized yesterday. Yeah, me too on the 5. That's be like, whoa, what, it rained a lot? Like, you're like, you got baptized on a freeway coming from California? Really? Anyway. No, dude, I think it's going to be great for you. We drove across country. Dallas is smaller. Smaller than I thought.
Yeah.
Because we did the turn in downtown, which is the book depository building.
Yes. Thank you for not saying suppository.
The grassy suppository knoll. And then the road, which apparently you jumped in the middle of?
Yes. So
I want to hear about that.
So I took my wife. We only had a brief moment to be down there because we were busy looking at houses and stuff.
And they're pregnant now, by the way.
Yes, we are. With triplets.
Oh, God. Your life's
triplets.
Going to
Huey,
suck for
Dewey,
about 20 years.
At Huey Lewis in the News. Those are the name of our three kids.
Huey Dewey.
So we were right there in front of the book depository, and they have on the street a little X. They have two X's. One where the president was first hit, and then the second one is where his brains blew out the back of his head.
Oh.
And I went.
Does it say that on the concrete?
No, I think they probably tried to be a little bit more tactful than using that language.
All right.
This is why I'm not in charge of naming things.
Yeah, well, I mean, or painting things.
Yeah, or or talking about things, or listening to things, or writing about things.
Again, we should be better.
So we should be better at this. So I stood right on the X, and I reenacted the whole back and to the left head exploding movement.
But
in between cars, as the cars were whizzing by, my wife was just absolutely embarrassed. I mean, just absolutely embarrassed.
Was she on the grassy knoll?
She was. No, I had her stand exactly where Zapruder shot his famous film. So she's standing in the same spot where the film of Kenny. And I stood in the middle of the street on the X and made my head go back and to the left.
Did she film it?
And to the left. She took pictures.
All right. No. Because back in the day, it was black and white and slow and everything.
Yes.
Did she have a wide angle lens like then? Because if you watch that video, you're like, wow, they are like a long way away from everything.
No, and it's so close.
I know. It's like from me to you right now, and that's literally too close.
So I'm not really a big, normally a conspiracy guy. I only have a couple of ones that I firmly believe. One, I believe that yes, we have been visited by aliens.
Yes, 100%.
I feel pretty confident in saying that. Two. I do believe that in 1986 that the NBA froze the envelope so that the New York Knicks can pick Patrick Ewing and get them with the number one overall pick. I think that was a rigged lottery pick. That's another conspiracy theory, I believe.
Don't know what you're talking about, but keep going.
And then the final one is, I've after visiting that spot twice now.
Oh, twice.
I've been there. I went there once before. I'll be honest with you. I don't
totally
see how Lee Harvey Oswald could have been. Maybe he wasn't the shooter. He maybe was with someone.
He wasn't
but
the
there's,
shooter.
I would put it at less than 10% of a chance that he was the only shooter.
I 100% agree, and I literally think that The Rock, the movie, the end of it, I think that's probably
you think
the
that's
real
how
JFK?
It went down?
Yeah, I think that's how it went down. Like, it's probably the film from it happening is probably in some recording is in some pew chair.
When you see how close the grassy knoll is,
it's like 10 feet away.
And what a perfect clear shot that would be, and how directly behind the grassy knoll, there's train tracks. And I'm not talking train tracks. I'm talking a convergence of 25 different railroad tracks all converging into one, all going off in different directions.
Yeah.
And they're like cargo, the ones. They're the kind that hobos jump on and off of.
Hey.
And when you see that, and then you see the angle that he would have had to have shot from the book depository building, it's like, on a moving target.
Oh, yeah, on a moving
target. By the way, moving away
slow
from him.
Yeah, farther away.
Right.
Yeah. He was just waiting for it to get right on top of that X. Where they were making sure.
And by the way, why would they paint an X on the floor and give him that target to shoot at?
I don't know. That's but very they surprising. Should have just put
and what are the odds that he gets shot exactly on the X that they painted all those years ago?
You know what? Back then, they were building roads. They didn't know what they were doing. I mean, they did the same thing up in Memphis when MLK got shot.
Yeah.
It was right in front of the hotel.
You know, even Martin Luther King Jr.'s family, his sons and daughters, even they don't believe that James Earl Ray shot their father.
I don't believe it either. And I went and saw the museum, and I went and saw everything that happened there. Dude, I'm not lying. If somebody did it that close and they didn't catch him, it's totally covered.
It's covered up.
Totally
and
covered
the other
up.
Thing that was odd about that one is the trees at the time, when they went back to take the photos that everyone has seen,
that by that time they had cut down all of the trees and the trees were trimmed. Mm-hmm. At the time of the killing, the trees were fully in bloom, which means this guy would have had to make that shot through like a pretty thick bunch of trees to
and
make
I've
this excellent
like
shot.
Like I said, I've been there. Have you been there before?
I've not been there.
Oh, my God.
But I've watched a lot of like stuff on
it
that.
It is amazing. If you ever get a chance to go to Memphis and go to the Civil Rights Museum, do it. I don't give a fuck what race or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
It is the most heavy museums I've ever been to.
Have you been to the Museum of Tolerance?
Every Friday night.
That was over by your old work there.
It was. It was Medieval Times, right?
Dinner and tournament.
No, but if you go there, I'm not lying, they show you the actual room. That you the,
well,
the,
you could actually go see it.
You walk right by it. The hotel is preserved, so the whole front of the motel is there. The concrete, the asphalt, and everything. A couple cars probably in there for aesthetic reasons, but the whole inside of that motel's been changed over. And then you walk across the street into the ground, and then you come out into the room where the guy, they say, was perched up and shot from.
Yeah.
So you get a perfect view, and if you look on the ground, there's a line that draws where the bullet went through. It's gnarly, and if you look at, I mean, the gun's there, the car that he ran away in, everything's there. It's all a conspiracy, man. Like,
yeah.
There's no way that all could have happened.
Now, the other conspiracies, like Elvis is still alive and stuff like that, that's not my jam, really. But
Elvis Costello died years ago.
Elvis Costello? You mean this guy? This bloke right here?
Don't do that again.
I'm just sitting down for an interview with my friends here from We Should Be Better at This. My
yeah,
name is Elvis Costello.
Elvis, can you answer me one question?
Of course. Tip, tip, cheerio. All right.
Pooping or peeing when you died?
Oh, I believe I was sitting there and I was pooping. Wait a minute, that's the other Elvis.
Oh, sorry.
I'm still alive.
Oh, sorry about that.
Can't you tell by my British accent that I'm doing so well?
Sorry, back to you in studio.
Ah. So basically, to sum it up, I'm moving to Texas, F California, and screw all of you.
No,
I hope you guys all have an earthquake and fall off into the ocean.
That's probably going to happen.
Yeah.
We will miss you. It's going to be our last live show.
It is.
Person to person. By live, I mean like sitting in the same.
Well, I don't know. I might not be alive.
That could be true.
Yeah.
Plus,
could be true.
I've had about three tall beers and
yeah. And we're gonna go out driving ATVs with our shirts off and no helmet.
That sounds like something you do in Washington.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it is Texas.
That is
bigger.
Texas, same thing.
Yeah.
It's just bigger ATVs.
Ooh, can you build a treehouse?
I could. I could even have a treehouse of horror.
Do you have trees?
Yes.
Like big trees, like treehouse
yeah.
masters.
Yeah.
Like you could do that.
Kind of. Yeah. I mean, I don't know how. I literally have no technical or building knowledge.
No. Not you doing it, because
oh,
we'd all
else.
Die.
Oh, we would all die.
But do you have
I would
trees?
Even kill the neighbor
yeah,
somehow.
Yeah, I mean, the trees would fall on their house.
Yeah. No, I do. I kind of have, in the front yard, there's two pretty good-sized, thick, mature trees.
All right, cool. Take pictures when you get there. Send them over. I'm going to chart out a treehouse, and when I come over, we will kill
build
ourselves
a
in your tree.
Yes, oh, my God. Wait. The amount of insurance waivers that are going to have to be signed for the two of us to have power tools.
It's a republic. They don't care. They're like, just don't die outside your fence line.
Okay, so let me ask you this. So I'm moving to Texas.
Right.
If you move to Texas, would you get a concealed carry permit license?
I pretty much have one right now.
Yeah?
Almost. Yeah, why?
No,
you?
I would. I'm thinking about it.
I thought you could open carry.
No, well, you have to have the license to do it.
Oh, I've got a license.
Yeah.
I just don't have a concealed weapons.
Yeah, you have to apply separately to a concealed weapons, and then you could literally walk into a grocery store and have like your holster on you.
Yeah. Nobody has to know either. You can just wear a sweater.
Yeah, you just wear a sweater.
No,
over.
But in Arizona, it's open carry. So unless it's a private property, which is most buildings,
but they have to disclose outside. You may not enter if you do have a weapon.
Correct. But if it's on your side, they obviously see it, so it's not concealed. It's open carry.
Right.
It's crazy, isn't that weird? But obviously, if I walked into a 7-Eleven and somebody had a gun on their hip. Not gonna rob the place.
Yeah.
Probably not.
Yeah. I was once doing business. I was doing business in Austin, Texas, one time.
What was their
and
name?
I don't know.
No, I love that name.
That's enough out of you.
That's like where I go to eat. Like, where you want to eat?
I don't know. Yeah, we just ate there last night. I was doing business in Austin, Texas, one time, and I was at this really nice bar. It was like a honky tonk type bar, but it was huge. And the sign on the outside says, be aware, people in here may be carrying weapons on their persons, blah, blah. It's like an official government sign.
Is Patrick Swayze the bouncer?
No, Roadhouse. So I go in there and I'm talking with a guy. I'm trying
Sam
to sell
Houston.
Him some product. No.
Okay, keep going.
And he goes, I say, you know, hey, that sign outside says that people may have guns here. Have you ever had a problem? You know, people get drunk. They want to start a fight. They want to whatever. Some idiot pulls out a gun. And he laughed and he goes, buddy, I could leave my cash register open walk away and go to the back. And when I come out, there's going to be the exact amount of change and everything that I have in there. He goes, because if one person reached over that counter, about 8 guns are going to be pulled on them.
Yeah.
And I said, so no one gets drunk and pulls out a gun? He goes, no, because everyone knows that everyone else has
guns. A gun, yeah.
I'm like, wow, it actually works. I didn't think it would work.
I mean, it's like no guns or all guns.
Right. There's yeah, the, like, it's
everybody's
the
afraid or everybody's
yeah,
a gun.
It's the medium that gets us into trouble. It's yeah. either no guns or all guns.
See, and that's how it is pretty much everywhere else in the world except for California and New York.
Yeah.
In any
and
major
is it funny,
cities.
Where are there more shootings and stuff?
In the major
think
cities.
About it, the three biggest murder states are well, Chicago for
Detroit.
For Chicago, Detroit, New York City, L.A., San Francisco. Gee, what do all those cities have in common? They have the strictest gun laws in the nation, so yeah. that only criminals have guns.
And that's the crazy thing is that right across the river, you got Canada from Detroit. Their murder rate's like 2%.
Yeah.
Detroit, like 75.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
everybody dies if
basically,
you basically,
if you have a family of four, yeah. three of your people yeah. there will die.
Eminem's only lived there because he built a compound.
By the way, does Eminem still make music? I haven't heard from
he
him
does.
In a long time.
He does. He's sober, though, so it's not good.
So it's not as good.
Not as yeah. good. But his daughter's, what? Like, super, like, hot.
Yeah.
So now he's probably just got, like, an entourage around her the whole
oh,
time.
Yeah.
He's like, nobody's impregnating her. I don't want to pay for that.
Man, I remember how big Eminem was. That was great.
Yeah.
That was when white boys were allowed to rap.
That's when white people are allowed to say white people.
Yeah, it's true.
But it's fine.
Yeah.
It's all good. He actually, I think he showed his chip online, I think 20 years of sobriety. And I commented, I'm like, quitter.
Yeah. Yeah, good job, loser.
Like, loser. No. But anyway, man, you're going to be missed. I can't wait to come visit you. Please take the pictures of the trees.
Absolutely.
So
that is a great idea. You know, I didn't even think about that, but you're right. I think there's some good-sized trees, and that would be a fun
one-bedroom
project.
Man cave. Not even one bedroom. One room man cave with a TV and a refrigerator.
I do have. I'm excited about this. I have a movie room in the new house. It's literally all it's going to be is a movie room.
Yeah.
I have the previous owner. We convinced them to keep all the stuff there, so it's all there when we move.
Wow.
But we have a full projector. A full screen and the sound wired into the walls.
Yep.
And we're just going to get some big, comfy lounge chairs.
That's awesome.
And we're going to hook the video game systems
no,
up to it.
No, love sacks.
We're gonna, ooh, love sacks.
Love sacks. Bean bags. But you'll want a chair.
Yeah.
And a love sack.
I mean,
you
know, my wife keeps telling me she doesn't like my love sack.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, you're talking about the brand.
This should be the red room.
Yeah, nice. So yeah,
this is basically where you're going to record your podcast from is what you're
saying. It's going to be my podcast room. It's going to be the movie room. I'm even thinking it's going to be my Bob Ross painting room.
Oh. You should
do
those live.
I can kind of like easily put a tarp down on everything and then just the movie screen
so
retract
the
movie screen retracts up in
oh.
at the press of a button so it retracts
what's behind it?
Some nice cupboards in the room. But this room is like really well done and it's like so perfectly done that we're like
up.
Not going to change a thing in it.
Yeah, that's dope.
Oh, I would tell you another thing. So when we were house hunting out there,
ooh.
We wound up looking at 42 houses when we were out house searching.
Jesus. How long were you out there for?
3 days.
Hold on. Wait, how many? 42?
42 houses in 3 days.
Days?
Yeah. We were on a mission.
You're still married?
Yeah. Hey, my wife and I, we have similar things. We don't like inefficiency, right? I like, boom,
that's true.
Let's go to the next place. Boom, let's go to the next
that
place.
That is true. If you put a schedule together, follow.
She'll follow it. Yeah. So we walk into this one house, and it was like, nice, but you could tell right away it wasn't going to be our choice,
yeah.
right? Like, the vibe wasn't right, whatever. But it was a nice house. Like, okay. There was nothing wrong with it, but you're just like, eh, it's just not really our thing. So we're walking upstairs, and we're exploring the house by ourselves. Our realtor is downstairs. And we're in the hallway, and this is a pretty big house. It's like 3,500 square feet.
Jeez.
So we're upstairs, so we have a lot to explore.
Three times the size of my house.
So we're walking upstairs, and we hear a sound. You know, it's totally quiet in the house, right? And we yep. hear a sound, and it sounds like a few thuds and thumps. What the hell was that?
Anne Frank.
She's hiding in there this whole
Seriously.
Time.
Seriously. She's still alive.
Still writing more diaries. Because her follow-up diaries got really racist.
Yeah, I mean, they were the bedtime diaries.
Yeah.
Or
yeah, it was a Red Shoe Diaries.
Yeah.
So we're walking through this house, and then we hear another thud. But it was kind of like a sudden thud that startled us. We're like, what the hell's going on?
Falls.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, okay.
And we're like, what the hell's going on? And we keep walking, and there's a room at the end of the hall that was all dark. And it sounded like the sound was coming from it. I'm like, okay, let's go down here. And we walked out to the end.
Red Mom.
These sons of bitches tried to trick me into buying their house. They were manipulating me. I cry foul. Because when I walked into that room, it was their movie room. And they knew that they were having visitors. They had Star Wars Force Awakens playing. Full sound turned up. Darkened theater, popcorn machine in the corner that had made popcorn, these big lounge chairs, and the sound, surround sound turned up like, that was the thuds we were hearing. It was the score.
Oh! Wait, hold on, hold on. This wasn't the house you bought?
No, this is
a
different house.
We're moving to Texas.
Fully set up, and they left it playing so that when the people came in, they would experience this movie room like playing, and it was part of the surprise. And I told Monifa, I'm like, we're buying this house. She goes, don't get suckered in. We're buying this house. She goes, don't get suckered in. Don't get suckered in. Okay. I'm like, I actually don't like the rest of the house, but we're buying this house.
I'm like, questions. Yes. Were there beds in that room? There be beds in that
there
room?
There could be beds.
Perfect.
By the way, it was
buy the house.
The room was bigger than our current living room and kitchen put together, and this was just the movie room. Oh, by the way,
Wait, hold on.
It was stadium seated. They had it
oh,
it's tiered.
Raised.
They had it tiered. So there was two
Ouch.
Seats in each row, and there were six total. So there was two.
This house.
No, it did not. And they had the Force Awakens playing, full surround sound, darkened room, mood lighting.
Is it still for sale?
Yeah.
I should probably look into it.
And it probably you could probably sell this house and go buy that house cash.
No. No, no, no. I have debt.
Oh, debt.
Like a lot.
A lot.
Like
of debt.
A lot. So I'm not leaving here
ever.
Because I can produce solar
and
I can produce a pool and they can't repo those.
They can't repo. They could, but they have to do it one spoonful of water, one bucket of water at a time.
Which would take them about 3 years. So I got a little time. It's like I'm squatting.
Yeah, you're squatting.
So,
all right. Well,
that's dope, dude. That's awesome.
We're excited. We bought a house. We are going to be I'm going to say 10 days away from being homeowners. We're still waiting for it to close.
For the first time in like 20 years?
Yeah. We bought
since
a house.
Since Chino?
Yeah, since Chino. Huh? That was the last time
we
owned a house.
That's when I lived with you.
Yeah, that's.
Holy shit.
Oh, that was
full
a long
circle.
Time ago, right?
Yeah. That was like 30 pounds ago.
Well, when your wife when your wife kicks you out, oh, it's my 30 pounds too. So when your wife kicks you out, we do have an extra room, so you're welcome to stay.
That's good, and everything's bigger in Texas so hopefully my penis swells.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for, too.
Is that what you're hoping for? I'm hoping my belly goes down a little bit, though.
Wait. What if you get both, though? Penis swells, but your belly gets bigger.
I hope it's not a dick do.
Yeah.
You know what dick do is?
No.
It's where your stomach hangs out farther than your dick do.
I'm getting there.
Please go to thisisfunner.com. Hit up Eric on Twitter, at Sinatra's Rat Pack. Tell him how stupid he is for not buying the house with the giant theater room. And only buying me a small theater room when I come to visit. And
hey, this is our last live show, but guys, we will still continue on. It'll just be all remote from now. But thank you for listening for these, 100 episodes or whatever the hell
we're
at.
We are close to 100 by now.
Yeah, right? Like we're in the
90s
or something.
Remember the 69?
Remember 69? It was a very short episode, just like normal 69s.
I think it's pretty much over right now.
Yeah,
it's normal 69. Yeah. Like,
it just lasted about 10 seconds until the novelty wore off. Anyways, please visit thisisfunner.com. Chris can do some great podcasts, and he can really help put together your dream podcast.
The funny thing is you're a lot heavier than your wife, so you must have been... all right, we got to go.
Anyways, all right, so we're out of here. Thank you for listening all these years. We appreciate your support, and please go support our other podcasts.
Yeah.
I do one called Listen to This. It's a great music podcast, and I will say this. I think my last episode, which was on colors, was the best one that we have done. It's my favorite one that we have done so far. But we have some great ones coming out, including one for Father's Day and a few others. I have one coming up called Wow, This Is Inappropriate, where it's just inappropriate songs.
That's the finale for season two.
There it is. That's the finale. So I appreciate you listening to that, and go to thisisfunner.com.
Yeah, and honestly, my favorite episode is the one about death.
Death.
It landed, I think, 2 weeks ago during COVID. It was perfect timing.
Perfect timing.
Yeah, I was like, we really planned that one out.
I'm going to do one on Black Lives Matter just to stay really topical.
Really?
No.
No, I wouldn't do that.
I wouldn't do that either.
White.
And I'm white.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to say that. But we
could
do a really cool show around the evolution of black music.
Yes.
Yeah, because.
I could.
Yeah, it'd be dope.
Yeah.
Figure that one out, white boy.
All right, white boy. All right, everybody. Thank you very much.
I'm not editing any of that out, by the way.
Son of a bitch. All right, bye.
Thanks.
The clearest sky is wide and high, deep in the heart of Texas. The coyotes wail along the trail, deep in the heart of Texas. The rabbits rush around the brush, deep in the heart of Texas.